Hey, yo, guys, it's me, Happy Cyric, and welcome to Last Day on Earth Survival. So right now, we're gonna be raiding this base named Wachi. And if we'll have some free time, maybe we're gonna do some convoy events and some other doo-doo. So here we go, we are inside of the base, and right now, I think I'm gonna loot this truck, and truck obviously is empty. And I have done a little bit of research on this base, and by the looks of it, okay, there's another room with C4. I didn't know it, man. All I know that there is this room, right? If I explode wall in this room, I know what I'm gonna get, but I don't know if I'll get something inside of this room. So I've done some research on YouTube, and by the looks of it, there will be a couple of chests in this room, but I am not gonna be exploding that wall because loot is really, really bad, and even probably inside of this room, right, loot isn't really that great, but in any case, let's explode that. Because I still don't know what kind of loot are we gonna get inside of this room, but I'm just keeping my fingers crossed that it's just gonna be better than nothing, so I think let's do 3 hits to all of these chests. So all these 3 chests are just 1 hit away from being destroyed. Now let's try to chop this chest down. And inside we got almost nothing. Well, stack of charcoal, let's definitely take that. And the rest doesn't really seem that valuable. And let's deal with this wave of zombies. Well, whatever, let's keep chopping down chests. And inside of this chest, we are gonna get a bow. God dang us, we got a bow. Should we take it? I'm definitely gonna take the bow with me to the base. Whatever. I mean, it's not like there is something else to take anyways. Let's take this 10 duct tape. These 10 duct tapes, another chest. And inside of this chest, we got a electronic circuit. And I believe... Wait, this is not my electronic circuit. Okay, let's take the electronic circuit then. Because this isn't a revenge raid. This is a real raid, so they did not steal my electronic circuit. Okay, okay. So far, it's pretty okay. I mean, really, I wasted a C4 for this. How can I say that it's okay? Okay, and in the last chest, we got a cleaver. Let's take a cleaver, baby. And another wave of zombies have spawned, so I believe that I am not gonna be killing them because, I mean, why waste your guns? Okay, so first of all, I gotta... juke them somehow. Well, here we go. Let's exit the base. And I don't want to spend too much time trying to raid this base, but gameplay-wise, 1. Loot-wise, 1. And overall score, 1. I'm at Bunker Alpha right now. Let's open up green crate. Let's open up this orange crate. I also have to go and shred 5 turrets and do the 4th floor for the raiders to do another raid. So that's what we are going to be doing today. But don't worry about it. We'll speedrun it. And we got another gas tank from this orange crate. Are you kidding me? Will I ever stop getting these gas tanks? You know what? I'm not going to say no to that. We're going to give this blueprint to the specialist. Here we go. Bada bing. And maybe we'll even do a little bit of hard mode bunker. But I kind of doubt it. Because it would be really cool to get my floppy crate. But we'll see. And a lot of people are asking me, Cyric, how do you do the 4th floor and blah, blah, blah. And the point is, for the 4th floor, you will need guns because there are these frozen zombies. And for these frozen zombies, you will definitely need to use guns because you can't use melee weapons as they heal every time they attack you. So it is going to be a bit more complicated. And the point is, if you don't have your burglar skill, then doing 4th floor isn't worth it at all. So if you don't have burglar skill, then don't worry about it. Don't even try to do it. At least in my opinion. As at the end of the 4th floor, there will be this chest. And at that chest, you'll be able to get a really, really great loot. But to get that great loot, you will need to use your burglar skill. And also this chest, I mean locker, you need burglar skill for that. So definitely do not waste your time doing 4th floor and resources. Because 4th floor is the most resource consuming place here. So here we go, this is the first turret. And I am gonna destroy this turret. But I don't think I will be destroying those hard mode turrets. Okay, we just leveled up. That's pretty cool. Let's go. Let's take my new skill. And it is gonna be, okay, less noise. I think it's pretty useless skill, but whatever, let's take that. So I'm not gonna be killing those 2 hard mode turrets because they're just soaking up a lot of M16s, and you can kill other turrets on the 2nd and 3rd floor, so that's what I am gonna be doing. But right now, I'll try to go and deal with these frozen bloaters. But before that, I'm gonna take my minigun, and maybe we're gonna do a little bit of damage with minigun. Here we go. They're healing up a lot, though. But still, minigun is pretty cool. I definitely think that minigun gets too much hate. Like, I think minigun does, like, 3,000 damage, so it's, like, Glock and a half. Like, unmodded Glock and a half, so minigun is definitely good. Well, the point is that turret cannot one-shot me anyway, so we're just gonna run past it just like that. Here we go, gonna heal up. Nothing have happened. Pretty cool. And I'm not gonna be destroying that turret on the down there as well, because who cares about it? Here we go. I'm gonna be fighting these zombies from over here. Hopefully not gonna die. Well, whatever. I have to use my minigun now. Hopefully gonna be able to shred him. Yes, indeed. It worked perfectly. Oh my goodness, let's take that. I can't do anything. I can't do anything, mate. Oh my god. Okay, so we can warm up on this corner. Okay, I thought that we were just gonna die. I really thought that we are gonna die there. I thought that's it. I thought my time has come. But well, in any case, let's get out of here. Let's kill that frozen bloater. It's not frozen bloater, it's frenzy giant. Let's go. Let's destroy the frenzy giant. Well, here we go. He did not even punch me. Let's go. Let's take his loot. And there are these 2 turrets, and I will definitely destroy them because, like I said, I need to destroy 5 turrets in order to do another raid, so... Let's do it. And here we go, there are more of these frozen bloaters, and just because of them, fourth floor is the hardest floor there is, because you cannot use any melee weapons on them, and they also have some protection, I believe, maybe, probably. Nah, they don't have any protection, they don't have any defense, but the point is, you cannot use any melee weapons on them, so you have to use guns, and that's why fourth floor isn't worth it. And there is also this some sort of generator, and I have no clue what that's gonna be about. Generator recharge. It will take time to restore electricity supply to lower floors. When the generator works at its full capacity, you'll be able to get there in the elevator. And I have no clue what this thing is even about. For those who did not know, before it was on the third floor, before the fourth floor introduction, the generator was on the third floor, but then they removed that generator from the third floor and they moved it to the fourth floor. But it looks freaking dope, and I don't know what it might be about. I believe that maybe one day we will need to like click on it, or maybe put some gasoline in order to open up the fifth floor, because I think it would be pretty cool, you know, to access the fifth floor. We'll have to do the fourth floor first, and fifth floor would be really, really cool. Because, I mean, now maybe fourth floor is kind of useful, because in the beginning it wasn't really that great, but now at least you can get some grenades, and, yeah, I'm not saying that fourth floor is the best thing that ever happened to Last Day on Earth. Definitely isn't the best floor, but at least now it's kind of doable. It's kind of okay, especially if you have True Friend's dog. Like, it is gonna be 50-50. But, like, I wish maybe fifth floor would be really, really worth it. So, in order to access fifth floor, you would have to do, you know, the fourth floor to activate that generator. I think that would be really, really cool. And, yeah. Except if the fifth floor isn't worth it at all, then it's not gonna be cool. But if the fifth floor contains, like, really great loot, some sort of unique items that you have to grind there all the time, then it would be awesome. And plus, we got 3 grenades. That's what I'm talking about. That's why it got a little bit more worth it in the recent updates. The fourth floor got a little bit more worth it in the recent update. That's what I'm trying to say. Because, I mean, in this other chest, we're just getting 1 steel plate and some aluminum, and it's not that bad, but sometimes we don't even get that. So I think we're done with the full fourth floor. I've just speedrun it. Nice. And right now, I will also speedrun a second and third floor just to kill these two other turrets, because I think it's more worth it to destroy these two turrets rather than destroying those two hard mode turrets, because they are just gonna soak up like your 2 M16s, and that's not really worth it. And plus, we got spread shots, so we can just deal with these roaming zombies just like that. Boop. Well, here we go. And this is the turret that I'm talking about. Let's try to shred it. And here we go. This was the fourth turret, and we still need to destroy one more, baby. And I don't have any other ranged weapons right now to destroy this turret, so I'll try to use my Glock. Hopefully it's gonna work. It should be working. Like, my Glocks are pretty decent, okay? Here we go. Glock's definitely working. Will my minigun work as well? Oh no, minigun does not work, man. Uh-oh. That is so sad, mate. But you know what? I'm not gonna give up that easily. Here we go. Gonna take now another minigun. Gonna take my bandages, and I should be able to survive easily. Let's go. Let's charge up my minigun. We still can heal up, and we're gonna destroy it. Here we go. We're done with 5 turrets. So some of you right now might be wondering, what am I doing here at police department? And like I said, I wanna definitely start doing police department a little bit more often, because I want to open up those 5 purple crates. And if I never do police department, I'll never be able to gather those 5 purple crates. So I took a couple of guns, because I think, like, I have already, like, 4 or 5 trunks of guns. I mean, racks, not trunks. Because I just keep gathering weapons and I never use them. So, let's at least grind here a little bit. And we're gonna get closer and closer to our goal of opening up 5 purple crates. And imagine how cool that is gonna be to open up 5 purple crates and get nothing. Well, I'll try to be a bit more optimistic. Maybe we're gonna get that grenade launcher for my AK or something else. And I really wanna start doing police department myself in my new account. And that's gonna be a bit harder, because you need here a lot of guns. So I'll have to maybe figure out on how many guns I have to save up, because in any case, without any active mods, I'll just have to use raw guns, and it's just gonna be pretty hard. And I also think that even opening up brown cards in my new account is gonna be kind of worth it, because I'll be able to get some sort of a melee weapon, and any sort of melee weapon is really appreciated in my new account, so we'll have to do something about it. And I also don't think that guns should be a problem. I believe we should be able to get enough guns from Bunker Alpha in that new account, so we'll see. I'm just excited for my first police department in that account. Just see how efficient that's gonna be. I'll try to maybe gather like 10 Glocks or something, and we'll try to do a lot of waves, because I think after 10 waves, I'll be able to get a lot of stuff, because maybe I won't even exchange those brown cards for something else, or maybe I will, because, you know, getting just brown cards is kind of meh, but I still think that brown cards are gonna be worth it. Life would be way easier if I just had at least 1 active mod in my new account, but it's impossible. There's no way I'll be able to get an active mod or open up purple crate in the beginning, because it takes a lot of grind and a lot of gun savings, so it's not that easy. And it will be really weird to use guns in my new account, because the point is, my whole point of that new account is to gather a trunk full of guns as soon as possible, because I think that's kind of a challenge and that's pretty fun to do. But at the same time, what's fun in just gathering guns? Maybe this way in my new account, I'll be able to develop some new strategies on how to do police department. But in any case, I have to get my burglar skill, because without that burglar skill, it will be pretty hard to do anything, because I need to get my grenades, and at least doing police department with grenades is going to be somewhat efficient in that new account, because without grenades, I'll just waste all of the guns that I have. So, well, let's hope that luck is going to be on my side. And also, if you watch that video where we will be able to use shields in order to fight, I think that will be really, really cool, because, I mean, let's actually test out. This is how he pushes me. Does it look the same? No, it doesn't look the same because he didn't push me with the shield. But the point is, I think we will be able to use the same or similar shield at Sector 7 if you watch that other video. And I think that's pretty cool. I don't think we'll be able to use it here in beyond Sector 7. But in that Sector 7, I think we'll be able to use it. I think you know what I'm trying to say here. And also, next update should be dungeons, if I am not mistaken. But again, maybe they're just going to bring something else, because by looking on that roadmap, they spoke about mercenaries and they removed those mercenaries. So I'm not sure. Maybe another update is just going to be bringing back mercenaries then. I think that is going to be kind of disappointing, because you know what? Like, I want them to introduce those mercenaries without another update, because it will be a bit sad. You know, we got mercenaries, they removed them. So we wait for 2 weeks and another update we get is again mercenaries, but we already had them. So it's not going to be that exciting. I want, if they're going to bring mercenaries back, I want something also in the game as well, because it's just going to be like same update that they've added in the past, at least in my opinion. But I want mercenaries back. Mercenaries were pretty cool. Like, it was a great idea to use mercenaries if you wanted to do a police department, bunker alpha hard mode. But I also can't wait for dungeons. I'm hoping that dungeons are going to change in how we play Last Day on Earth, because currently, like, we just have to use guns. And the point is, it's not really that fun to use guns all the time, because I'm getting a lot of melee weapons and I don't use melee weapons almost anywhere, because there isn't a single cool place where you can use your melee weapon. So it would be better, it would be cooler if they added some sort of a, like, can I PP somewhere? Because I want to PP. Yes, I can PP here right now. And what I try to say is that it would be really great if they added some sort of like a police department version just with melee weapons. That would be really cool. So I'm hoping that that's what dungeons are going to be. Or even if at dungeons, we won't be able to use melee weapons, if we'll have to use guns. Like, I'm going to be happy about that anyways. I just want some sort of a new place where I could grind and get some sort of new loot. Because if dungeons are going to be cool, but they're not going to bring anything new, then I don't think they will be successful. Like, I think their dungeon success is going to be all dependent on how good loot there is and how unique loot there will be. Well, I took here a lot of guns and I'm almost done through all my guns, but this is almost 20th floor. And from these 20 floors, if I ever done them in my new account, I think I would get super rich. But again, I would use here a lot of guns, so I don't think I'd be able to get those guns back, but I would get a lot of melee weapons for my bunker alpha and I wouldn't have to craft them. But again, melee weapons are pretty easy to get. Just grind for some iron and that's it. So, well, in any case, I will have to do police department myself in that new account in order to know if police department is worth it or not, really. Well, let's do one more wave and then I'll try to pick up all these cards, and maybe I'll get 2 blue. If I'm gonna get at least 2 blue, I'll be happy and then I'll be able to finish this. And I do know that some people might be asking me why I do this police department without any armor. And like I said, you just need hair shoes. You don't need any armor, because it's just gonna be waste of your inventory, waste of your space, waste of your armor, and etc. and etc. You just need shoes if you don't use grenades here. So whatever, let's start looting the place. Well, I still have a couple of guns left, but I had almost full inventory. So whatever, let's pick all that up. I mean, you know what? Let's just keep picking up. If I'm gonna get something, I'll say something. And you know what? Whatever, let's just do snap transition. Well, I picked up everything and this is what I got. And to be honest, this is almost nothing. After 20 waves, this is really nothing. So I'll try to use a couple of more guns. Maybe I'll be able to get at least more blue. At least one more blue, dude. Well, I've done 25 waves and I've run out of all the guns. I just have 2 shotguns left. And this is what I got. This was seriously one of the worst police departments that I've done. This is sad. This is disappointing. So let's try to do quickly a motel with my shotgun, because I don't really have any other weapons. I just have one more shotgun here. And I still didn't even clear my inventory. I didn't go back to the base. The only reason why I came here is to take my energy drinks and to go and get that grenade. And this is also another reason why I want to get that burglar skill. I mentioned it so many times, but you know what? Let's actually maybe make a poll. Maybe it will be up the top somewhere over here right now. Do you have your burglar skill? Like, that's really interesting for me. I want to know how many people have burglar skill, like at least percentage, if it's something really rare or something really common, or leave your comment down below if you have it or you don't have it. And finally, we got an energy drink. So this is pretty cool, because I'm pretty scared by the looks of it. Some people say that they still don't have burglar skill even after level 100. So I'm kind of worried that maybe in my new account, I'm going to be kind of screwed, because grenades would save up a lot of items. But you know what? I've played the game even before the grenades and I was able to get a lot of guns. So I don't think that grenades are really, really useful. I mean, the grenades are of course useful, but I don't think that grenades are going to be essential key of getting rich in Last Day on Earth. So you know what? Even if I don't get the burglar skill, we still should be able to get that trunk full of guns. So whatever, let's loot this place and please give me one grenade. I mean, it should drop. Of course, we got a grenade. Nice. So we're still getting one guaranteed grenade all the time. And maybe I even should do a motel in my lower level account. Like, we need here just a spear and a couple of hatchets. So I think we could get here some pretty decent loot. It feels kind of bad of using, of wasting my shotgun over here, but I don't have any other gun. So hey, we gotta do what we do. And let's try to loot the car. Maybe inside of the car, we're gonna get something nice. And we got a katana. Okay, let's take that. Better than nothing, probably. I mean, for the new account, that would be great. I kind of start seeing how motel is great. Like, for new players, motel might be pretty dope. So definitely, probably, maybe next time in my new account, we're gonna go to motel and we'll try to judge the loot by it. So I'm not sure how long this video is gonna be, but I've been recording here way over an hour. And I think it's gonna be pretty short because, like I said, I try to keep them as short as possible and as entertaining as possible. So make sure to smash that like button if you didn't smash it yet for the effort. And also make sure to follow me on Instagram or Twitter at @epicyberg, because why not? I highly suggest you checking out this horror game Let's Play Visage. Just click here on the first card and you'll go check the way there. Click here on the second card and you'll watch a recommended video just for you. And I'm uploading such videos on YouTube every single day, so make sure to drop that subscribe button and notification bell to not miss any future videos. Also, guys, drop that like button while we're at it, and peace out. Mm-hmm. Yep.